We both about to say something. So the last time was in front of a bunch of wine bottles. They weren't empty, but these are. And the reason why they're empty is mainly because of the man standing to my right. If you've seen the last episode of Out the Box TV, then you know what I'm talking about. We're at another place, another location, saying dope shit. It's your boy DJ PrimeTime256. Don't forget the 256.
Your man RoJay, man. We're checking in on an event that we dropped in on a couple of months ago. Mm-hmm. Praising the Park.
Yes.
Doing a quick recap on that for y'all.
Hey, man.
Then we're talking to our man Branden Gaddis, mm-hmm. Victory Brand, and Dapper.
With the watches. And the ties. So it sounds like you can get holy during this episode, right? You can get a dope watch, timepiece, right? And you can get a little fitted with your Dapper collection.
It's all about being fresh.
Out the Box TV starts.
Your man RoJay here, out the box with the one and only Jekalyn Carr. Very excited to meet this one right here because I've been playing your song Jehovah Jireh and just been losing my whole mind right there. First of all, I want to know how you pick such a, how you fit such a grown voice in such a little package.
Listen, it's all God. Okay. I can't explain it.
Okay, so you've been doing this thing for a minute. Like, you actually broke more than 3 records before you was even a good young. She's been doing this thing for a while, and I just became familiar with you here not too recently, but I was just, when I heard you, I was like, that girl got some oil on her voice right
Thank you.
You know what I'm saying? So when you're laying out, you just did a live a version. How do you approach a live album differently than you would approach one that you do in the studio?
All of my professional albums have been live. Okay. And so I just love the live experience. I'll do studio, because like the song that I getting ready to release next week, it is a studio version, a studio song. And so, but for the most part, I love album. I go and give it the best I have.
Okay, she like to feed off the energy of the crowd, because
yes.
I know how you feel sometimes. You need to let them know you touching them.
Yeah.
Just a little bit. I just touched you right there on the hem.
No,
right
and
there.
I think my people, they're accustomed to that. Mm-hmm. All of my supporters, and they love it as well. And so I just love it because it's also a personable moment as well that we have.
Your man RoJay out the box with the one and the only James Fortune. What it do?
Man, it's so good to be with you, my guy.
Yes,
man.
Sir.
It's my brother right here, man. Thank
so
you
so
me.
Many, so many titles I can give you. Because you got a lot of hats that you wear.
Yeah.
So you just gotta let me know what's the latest thing you got going on.
Well, you know, working on some new music, but also, you know, Fortune Live Talent is doing great. The talent show I do where people are able to come on there and just whatever their talent is, singing, rapping, spoken word. And it's really been a blessing to see how it's really taken off and people are really connecting with it every Monday night.
Yeah. Now, you've been blessing people through that network as well. I've been seeing the little giveaways and little
absolutely.
Love offers you're giving people.
Yeah,
and
man. So we
how did you get
can.
The idea to start that?
I think people was always asking me to come on and sing or come on and, you know, like, hey, I want to sing for you. Hey, I want you to hear it, you know. So I was like, you know, when Instagram started doing where you could add another person, I said, well, I'm going to just start adding people to Instagram and letting them sing or praise, dance, whatever they do. And so, you know, if you look through my career, I've always kind of liked sharing my platform, right, you know, with other artists, with other gifts that I think need to be heard, you know, need to be experienced. And so that's just kind of how that happened, man. Another opportunity for me to give people to really be able to reach back and give back.
Out the Box TV, your man RoJay. I had to put my shades on for this because I'm talking to one of the coolest guys right
here. Let's go.
Making things happen right now. Pastor Mike, Jr., how's everything going with
I'm
you?
Excited to be here, man. Honored to be in the city. Love what you're doing and glad to be a part.
Gotta love it. Now, you just won Best New Artist at the Stellas.
No, Artist of the Year.
Artist of the Year, I'm sorry.
That's right, yeah. Best New Artist last year.
So he's making things happen. Nominated for a Dove Award as well.
Yes, right, yeah.
So he's making a lot of noise. Number one single, too.
Yeah.
I've been killing it on my show right there.
Thank you, bro.
It's been speaking to a lot of people. What was your motivation behind this song?
Just trying to bring some inspiration. People don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. And in the midst of all the stuff we got going on, we just need some hope. And it's a bifold song. You know, God saying, whatever you need, I got it. But if you've been ready to go to a job interview, you can ride and say, I got it, I got it.
Right.
So just some inspiration and motivation for the people.
That's self-affirmation.
That's right.
You know what I'm
saying? That's right.
I know for sure you hold a lot of titles right now.
Yeah.
Pastor and artist.
Yeah.
How are you balancing it out?
I'm finding it out just like everybody else who's pregnant with vision. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. You know, like yesterday, I got on a plane late at night to get right back in Birmingham so I wouldn't miss my boys' football game. Then right back up this morning, came all the way to Huntsville. So sometimes you just got to find out what's going on. So for me, if you're listening, I deal in orbit, not order. So most people go order, 1, 2, 3, 4. I go orbit. In other words, my purpose revolves around the S-O-N.
Okay.
So whatever is calling me at that time that's greater, that's what I prioritize and it hasn't failed me yet.
We are here, Out the Box TV. I'm with Edwrin Sutton. Now, this is a man that wears many hats, right? Many hats, all up and down the Christian community. And I'm gonna let you explain a couple of different things. Right. First and foremost, tell everybody about yourself and what you do for a
I wear many hats because I'm bald, number one. That's why I wear many hats. But I'm Edwrin Sutton. I'm a pastor, an author, recording artist. And I'm just so glad to be with you all in Huntsville today. It's an honor to be here with you.
So where are you from?
I'm from Wilmington, North Carolina.
Oh, wow.
I was pastoring in New York. But my wife and I, we decided to start a church all the way in North Carolina. We started the church a couple months ago. And already a little over 70 members. So a growing church in the midst of a pandemic.
Wow.
So a lot has changed. So
pastoring and music, how does that go hand in hand?
I'm still trying to figure that one out. there's so many, you know, who do it. John P. Key, Hezekiah Walker, Donnie McClurton. And so music is just a part of me. Mm. And so with the pastoring piece, it's a perfect measure, marriage for me.
What got you into passion? Were you already into the music piece already? Yeah. Like growing up into the church, being into music,
I was in music first, but I grew up in the church. Family members who are pastors, and sooner or later, I just knew that was my call as well. Mm-hmm. So I've been doing this for 10 plus years.
Okay. Now, you got an album coming out.
Album out.
Album out already. Album out already.
It came out July, I'm so thankful. It's called The Revival. Mm. It debuted number 5 sales in the nation for gospel music. And I believe on Billboard it was 20 something for hot gospel albums. The Revival, my first project, and I'm so proud of it.
Man, I'm here with Dante Pride.
Yes, sir.
Now, before you tell the world about you, right? I need to know when you go on tour, you know what I'm saying? If you got a DJ, but tell me something. Well, first of all, I'm gonna tell everybody about you, tell them what you do.
So I am a Christian hip hop artist. What I do, man, I believe, man, church is outside of the four walls, man. So we being more than just the church, man. We be in the street. We just want everybody, man, just to know about Jesus, man. And to know it ain't God's will for our life to be broke Christians, you know what I'm saying? So we believe in living in the overflow.
Not broke Christians. He said, not broke. You ain't got it. You can be a Christian and not be broke. But I got to correct you on something.
It's all about mentality.
I got to correct you on one thing.
What you got?
You said you're a hip hop, right?
Yeah.
A hip hop Christian, right?
Yeah.
You a rock star, bro.
Bro.
Let me tell you, man. So every time I sing your live performance, it goes up,
man.
Right? I don't know where your hat went. You hit the Bobby Shmurda on him. Like, he threw his hat up, and the Holy Ghost caught it. And I just know he was just, next thing you know, he was going on the stage, man. Like, hey, what helps you with that type of energy coming on stage? Like, what's your goal when you get out there? What do you want to give to the people when you out there?
Man, literally before every show that I do, man, my number one prayer is, God, don't even let it be me. I want you to just take over and do what you do. And that's why every single show, I get nervous before every single show, bro.
Really?
Because after I say that, I don't even know what's about to happen next.
You just get let it roll. Let's roll from there.
Let's get it.
And then your drummer. Who's your drummer?
Malik Adams.
Bruh. Shout out to Malik.
Shout out to Malik Adams. Bruh. And I got Trey Calhoun as well. So they both on the team.
Bruh. I'm talking about, you can tell, first and foremost, I appreciate the artistry. Right? You can tell that you just don't get out there on a whim and do it, right? You got a message when you do it, and you want to make sure that the people get the message.
Yeah.
So first and foremost, I appreciate that. But before we get out of here, let everybody know where we can find you at, where we can follow you at, and what you got coming on next.
So man, y'all can follow me at I Am Dante Pride on Instagram, Dante Pride on Facebook. And man, I got an EP coming out. Should be out in October. It's gonna be out in October. So that's the other thing, man. I had to learn to quit procrastinating. You gotta write this stuff down. Gotta have it dated.
Because
if you got it written down, you know it's gonna happen.
You gotta have a completion date, man.
Yes, sir.
Out the Box TV, Dante Pride, man. Hey, DP, are you with me? Oh yeah.
We have the church. We ain't going nowhere.
DP, let's get it. Welcome back, another episode of Out the Box TV. It's your boy DJ PrimeTime256, and before I even get started, let me do something. I'm gonna go ahead and take this off, because I don't even want to be disrespectful, because you see what we got here. You see what we got here. Let me go ahead and put this off. Man, I'm gonna introduce a brand that really doesn't need any introduction, but if you're new to the watch game, and you got money, because when he travels, he just don't go anywhere, so you can't catch him at your mom and pop stores, even though he'll ship to you. You feel me? Don't get it twisted. He'll shit to you. But shaking hands with millionaires, to on yachts with millionaires, to selling your watches across the world, man. Branden, how you doing, brother?
I'm doing good, brother. Doing good.
Man,
good.
I know I hyped you up, but you know what I'm saying?
Tell the people about
your brand, what you do, what you stand for, and what you got out here.
Man, so Victory Brand is my name of my company. Victory Brand. Faith is timeless, man. It started with just a dream, man, back in January 1st, 2019. Literally, God gave it to me, and I was just like, man, start a timepiece business? What? And me? And I was always fascinated about a timepiece, because every time you look at a man's watch or on his wrist, it does speak volume.
Right,
I looked
right.
up to that, you know, talking about a young man that grew up going to church and seeing deacons and pastors and stuff wearing these nice timepieces and suited and booted. But it was one of those things that inspired me, and that was like, and I was like, God was like, start your own, something that represents me. And so that's what I did. It was basically a dream, and this is what you see. Mm-hmm. The dream is now into action.
Now it's real.
And it's real, man. It's so real. So that's what you're seeing, all the timepieces that you have.
So now, Faith is Timeless. What made you choose that?
So Faith is Timeless as our slogan, man, because, you know, we serve an unlimited God. So I was like, man, he never leaves us or nor forsaken us. So I was like, let's go with it, man. He's always with us.
Mm-hmm.
So now we just have to exemplify faith unlimitedly, even though sometimes it can be a struggle. But when you keep your faith, even if it's small, you still got it. It's still gonna be worth it later on.
You're gonna make me start shouting out. You better stop
telling you, bro.
You better, hey,
you seeing something?
A timepiece that'll make you catch the Holy Ghost. Watch out. Hey, wear it on Saturday night, you'll be forgiven on Sunday morning. Amen. Amen. Because you know why? Because faith is timeless.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hey, now tell us about, you got Genesis and you got purpose,
yeah.
Right? Tell us about what's the Genesis, what's the purpose,
and
what do we have here?
Listen here, bro. So, as you can see, in the middle, our middle five here are our Genesis series.
Uh-huh.
This is our special edition, a Rival Gold edition, which is a special one. This was our seventh men's timepiece that we introduced. We started off with only two. So this is what birthed it. So we have our Genesis Gold, which is the regular gold. This is the Genesis Gold that birthed Victory Brand, and our Genesis Black, which were our first two styles that we started with. And then we have here is our Genesis Pearl, and then we have our Genesis Blue here. And then, did I miss one? And I didn't. So we good to go. So these are all our styles. So our Genesis Pearl, Genesis Gold, a Genesis Arrival Gold Edition, and our Genesis Black, and our Genesis Blue right here. So that's all of those for the Genesis. Of course, Genesis is the first book of the Bible, so it was the beginning. So it was the beginning of our series, and I was like, well, it's catchy, let's keep the theme going.
Yeah.
And with the brand, man.
And what about the purpose?
So the purpose, man. So purpose, man, it was like, at the season I was in, I was trying to, you know, we had to find our purpose. So with this, I found my purpose within this, man. So by trade, man, I went to school for telecommunications and performance. And the business was so hard for me and everything, and being valued as a host and everything. And I was like, man, how can I ever find my purpose? And I love speaking, whatever. But through this brand, man, it's given me the ability to speak with y'all. And talk about my purpose, and I love speaking, so that's what the purpose series is about. It's our leather bands, which is, you know, it speaks volume, and I love leather band watch, because you can switch it up, you can wear casual. you can wear it however, dressy, whatever. So that's why the purpose series is what it is, man.
And I'm just gonna put this, what's your pricing on this? Because this is, I'm not gonna lie,
okay.
I took out my watch and I was hoping he was gonna be like, yeah, brother, hey, go ahead and holla at your boy on this one. But man, you do got reasonable pricing, but specifically this one. How much? What this one?
This one right here is our Genesis Ghost, which is $235 online. So yeah, $235 for this one. Our Rival Gold Edition, which was our special make, was $270. It's $275, and all the Genesis series besides the Rival Gold Edition is $235, and our Purpose series is $205. So I try to keep the prices, you know, reasonable, but also I want to present luxurious. I wanted to present excellence. So that's why you see these bags, these velvet bags that we have. I get joked on because people like that Crown Royal. I'll be like, no, it's that Victory brand.
It's that Victory.
What it speaks volume. So my goal is with the brand was not just to reach the churchy crowd and just stay in there in that realm. I wanted to reach people all over because that's what it's about. It's not just staying in one place, man. And so with us, we need to go out here and reach, man, whatever. So when I see people wearing it out, man, it was cool. Like, I went to the Tank concert as a vendor, and I saw a couple of my customers
out there riding
like,
the watches,
wearing a timepiece, man. It was just like a blessing, homecoming. And people seeing people wearing it at home, at A&M homecoming. It was just like, wow, this is something that started as a dream, and now I'm seeing it in other people's wrists. And I was like, man, I can keep doing this.
And my last question, man. Come on, now. You got a number three, or the Roman numeral three. Ooh. What is that about on there?
Yes, sir. The Roman numeral three, man, it represents the Trinity, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, man. That's what it represents. It takes all three to survive, man. And that's it's really my story on your wrist.
Right.
Because I knew I was in a place where I was in denial of what God was doing. Like, I was just like, nah, I'm good. You did what you did, Lord, I'm good. And then everything failed. But when I stay consistent with him and kept my faith with him, instead of trying to put my way in it and started putting his way in, I started to see the benefits. And that's why you see what you see now.
Most definitely, yeah, most definitely. So let the viewers know where we can find you at, where we can purchase the product.
Yes, so you can find us at www.victorybrand.co for company.
Co.
So not .com, .co for Victory Brand. So also, you can also find us at Instagram and Facebook at Victory Brand Co as well. So Victory Brand Co, keep the brand the same.
C-O.
Because I'm telling you, we're trying to expand. We don't just want to stay into the timepiece realm, but we want to be able to get some apparel too. So that's why we didn't just put ourselves in the box. We out the box. You feel me?
Hey.
So we out the box. So you see us. We're not just in the box. We also out the box. So
let's go.
Victory Brand is where it's at. So I pray that y'all, you know, support this brand. You will love it. You will love the quality. And DJ Primetime is no joke. This is great quality. He's touching it himself. And yeah, my brother is about to be blessed with one. You know? Let's go.
Mm. Man, well, hey, I appreciate you, man. I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna tell you right here. I'm gonna buy one of these watches. Hope I get on. I ain't gonna ask him, hope I get on discount. I don't want it on discount. I'm gonna pay full price. That's what you should do, man. Support your local vendors. Support, hey, anybody, everybody. RoJay, you better get a piece too. I'm gonna put you on the spot too, but I'm going home with this one today. I'm going home with this one, man. So, hey, appreciate having you, man. Out the Box TV.
Yes, sir.
RoJay, back to you. Out the Box TV, your man RoJay. I'm here with DJ, a very dapper dude, as you can see. Pun intended. Because y'all here doing your thing, man. And I've heard your name in the city for a while now. So I was like, I got to reach out.
Appreciate it, man.
And talk to this young man right here because you're an entrepreneur and you're a businessman and you're doing all this good stuff. And you started out just kind of making things for yourself and it kind of grew into something. So tell me a little bit about the background of Dapper Dude.
So yeah, basically, like you said, man, I started making bow ties for myself. And I'm sure you found that sometimes it's hard to find pieces that you like.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, I was like, well, let me figure out how to make it. I have no excuse. I'll go ahead and make it, and I'll get the pieces that I want. So that's kind of how I started learning how to make it. People were asking for it, so I was like, well, let's see if we can start a business out of it, man. Okay. So it was really, really kind of that organic. It was like, well, I like these pieces. People started liking them, so I decided to share them with everybody else.
Basically, what he's saying, he was showing out. He was so fresh.
He was flexing
out here in these streets, and they was like, where can I get some of that? Like, I feel you.
I'm not sure if it was that, but yeah.
Okay. But you got a style all your own. Now, did you always have this style where you like viewed as that's the weird kid type situation, or because you grew into creating your own pieces, the style grew organically from that as well?
I think that I've always been eclectic. I've had people from my high school tell me, yeah, man, you used to have style when you were younger. I'm not sure how good it was then, but they said that I did have a pretty decent style. I know I was always wearing bright colors when I was young, so okay. Maybe that was my flair.
Right.
So where I went, we had to wear uniform.
Okay.
So really the flair was our shoes or, you know, something like anything to kind of break from that uniform because, you know, most creatives don't like uniforms.
Right, right.
So just always trying to figure out a way to kind of break from the uniform. Or I like shopping at a thrift store, so you know you have to come up with pieces from the thrift store. Like when you go to a thrift store, it's not something set up for you to wear.
Right.
You have to figure it out.
Right. Going to a thrift store stresses me out. Let me just say this. No, it stresses me out because I already hate shopping.
Okay, okay.
I literally hate shopping. I'm talking about from groceries to clothes. I hate online shopping that stresses me out. But I get people that when I do find something, they be like, that's dope or where you get that. But I promise you, I was in a rush. I really wasn't trying to come up with nothing. It's something I threw together. Like, I'm big on clearance. I'm on the clearance rack.
There's nothing wrong with clearance,
I'm on the clearance rack because I'm kind of frugal when it comes to zero. I've grown over the years. I spend some money now, but I was always clearance. So whatever was on clearance was for me. How do you actually, like, when you go to a thrift store and you just start, like, how do you know what's that piece? Like, do you build around that, or how do you throw that together?
So for me, and what I hope to try to help people figure out is you kind of have to have an idea of what your style is first. So
okay.
So when you're going in there, I know. So say like this little jacket right here. I know that this jacket, green army jacket, can go with anything.
Okay.
So that's a staple piece that I can get. I'm looking for pieces that will always go with pretty much anything in my closet so that I don't have to think about dressing.
Gotcha.
So that's really the key, just finding things that I know I like. And once you train your eye to see those things are going to jump out at you.
Okay.
So like when you see a car that you like and you want, I'm not sure what your favorite car is.
See, that's a problem with me. I can tell you about music. I can tell you what my favorite song is. That's a mood for me.
Okay.
Anything that in regards to shopping, like even when I was car shopping, that was stressful because I don't know what's in, so to speak.
Yeah.
I know what I like.
Well, but when you saw, when you figured out what you liked, you always see that car or whatever everywhere.
Right.
So that's basically what you're training your eye to see.
Okay.
So once you say, hey, I like that, then your eye starts seeing that more and more and more, and that's really all you gravitate to.
Right.
You're not worrying about the other fluff. So that's why for me, it's kind of easy to just go in a store, grab stuff, and get out of there. I ain't got to worry about it.
Okay. So he's saying he makes his trips quickly.
Yeah.
I'm just like, okay, I get it. Okay. So lapels, pocket squares, bow ties, all of this is a learned skill for you. But it turned into like a great venture for you. Now you're in a location where people can come and see your product.
Yep.
So what made you move to the established location situation type of thing?
I just got tired of meeting people in Starbucks, man, all the time. You know, it's fine, but it's a little more professional. You can create a better experience when people can come to you, sit down, talk about what they're trying to get done, and I can actually bring clothes here, help them. I couldn't do that, you know, at that type of location. So this just allows me to create a better experience for the customer.
Got you. I love that. So before we get everybody where they can contact you and everything, I know you got the brand on, you're expanding.
Hey,
tell me a little bit about the things that you're expanding on from the bow ties, lapels, pocket squares. Like, where are you taking Dapper Dude next?
So the plan always has been to create pretty much an entire look for my guys and to make it easier for my guys and girls, to make it easier for them to confidently get dressed up. So I'm going to be doing pants, shirts, jackets. Probably not going to be doing the shoes just yet. That's a whole other level. I have bags, so I have bags coming. Actually, here's some of them up here.
Okay.
So pretty much everything that you can think of that you would want to wear is what I'm going to have in the Dapper Dude collection. Yeah, so that's where we're going.
And classic is timeless. I understand that. I know you like the clean cut classic style with a little flair.
Yeah, a little flair.
I've noticed that, so I like that. So y'all may see me getting dapper soon. I don't know. Because I'm a jeans and t-shirt kind of guy. But I do step outside here and there, like. And when I do, that's when I get noticed doing stuff. So I'm just gonna be extra now.
So let me style you one time.
I'm with that. Y'all with that? They with that. We're gonna make that happen.
Bet.
Gonna make that happen. All right, how can they contact you on social media?
So you can catch me at _DapperDude or on Facebook. Well, that was at IG, but on Facebook at the Dapper Dude Collection. Or if you just want to come down to the shop, it's 2801 Governor's Drive South. Wes,
okay. Right?
Yeah, 35805. Still trying to get used to it.
In this thing.
Yeah, we hit up. But yeah, so just you go to my page and you can hit the book now. So I'm doing bookings now. It makes it easier so I can give you a better experience coming in one on one.
Gotcha.
Kind of deal. But that's how you can reach me.
Y'all know what to do. Hit my man up. I'm going to have him style me. I'm going to let them know exactly that I'm in the Dapper Dude collection. And which episode and all that stuff, and we're gonna tag my man right here. He gonna work with me, all right? He gonna work with Mr. Clarence Rack, okay?
I got you.
All right, we'll be back right here, Out the Box. Let's go. Thank you for tuning in to another episode of Out the Box TV. Had a great time today. Shouts out to our man, Branden Gaddis, and my man, DJ with Dapper Dude. Mm-hmm. And, of course, all the talented people that dropped in on Praising the Park.
Amen. So, folks got saved. I think RJ did a backflip. You did a backflip, you bought a tie, you bought a watch. You spent some money this episode. We need y'all to spend some time, amen. Hey! Watch out!
Like, share, comment. Tell another friend. And if you ain't got no friends?
If you ain't got no friends, we're your friends. Only if you like, follow, and share. Because if you don't, we ain't your friends either. Out the Box TV, we out!